in and around the site, just to keep everything quite quiet.
We're a beach sand story, but of course we're here for a friend. Now and outside it in the kitchen.
Whoa! Whoa!
Walking you home along that burning street. You tell me secrets I was shocking on. Saying it was me every night. And after the end of the same post, so do you. I come and visit, maybe never come. Follow you to bed and tomorrow. And stay awake all night. We repeat the same stories, but it was never a friend. Out outside in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Run around to morning and we'll stay awake all night. We repeat the same stories, but of course, but we're a friend. Out outside in the kitchen. Young man, pushing the shoulder down. Young man, pushing the shoulder down. Young man, singing to the baby a punk rock song. Bodies! Young man, pushing the shoulder down.
Give a sponge round. Lemonheads and card bottom cloth, here they are.
There's a disease going around the hospital.
I recorded it just because I remember he forgot we wrote it, but we actually did write the song together, right? And you know what the problem was, is that it's actually he wrote Roll With It, like based around, this is rather incriminating, isn't it? But no, sorry man, but the whole problem was that the song went purple parallelogram, you gotta roll with it, so basically, like, it couldn't be put out because he had already put it out on his own record.
But I've never seen it before.
gotta roll with it, you gotta take your time. Say what you say, don't let anybody get in your way, cause it's all too much for me to take.
But Noel Gallagher doesn't seem too sure about his contribution.
Let's just say the memory's a bit hazy from now then. I don't actually recall writing this tune. So I got a tape of it the other day, and it doesn't sound like one of mine. It doesn't sound like one of his. So I don't know, but I can't remember. So, but I'll definitely take the check if anyone's giving any money away. I mean, I'll get that. But...
there's no bad blood from me towards Oasis, and I'm sure none's coming back at me, because like, I love those guys. They're like, they're really, really like fine examples. Mad for at night.
Even Dando has never hidden or denied his use of drugs, but things may have changed now.
I renounce all evil. I'm too old to take hard drugs anymore. This is like too damaging and dangerous.
Despite being 29 and having the passport to prove it, age is not the only reason for this new attitude.
I couldn't continue with my drug abuse because it was going to kill me. I have a goddaughter now, and I have responsibilities, you know, and I'm never mind my selfish like love of experience, right? It keeps me made me stop taking hard drugs because I want to stick around to see what's going to happen. That's all. The only reason why I stay alive is because I'm really curious about what's going to happen next, you know? I won't be someone else. I'm too much with myself. I want to be, like, in control and alert when the apocalypse comes. Otherwise, it won't be much fun. I won't be someone else.
Evan Dando.
Ah.
Lemonheads.
Mm.
Welcome.
Mm.
So we've been hearing lots about you and all of your famous friends and sure. all of your various adventures and that.
Mm. I have several.
Yeah, what would be your version of events up until this point since last we heard from the Lemonheads?
Well, a goat held up a 7-Eleven. He was an escape goat. And I jumped back into the sun, and I discovered my ultimately cool squirrel toenail world. And the rest is sort of Michael Jackson.
Right, would you care to tell us that in a way that maybe most people could kind of get
Pros.
More of a lock on it?
Yeah. Right. I gave myself a break from the world and the world a break from myself.
That was nice of you.
Yeah, exactly, because we both needed it.
So when you were making the record, did you feed off what had happened to you, or did you go deeper inside and pull something else out?
I looked straight within instead of looking like for approval from other people. I looked for approval from myself with this record, if you must know the truth.
Something close to it would be nice. So, what does it sound like? Well, that's, you know, if your
what
version
does it sound
of the
like?
Yeah, what does it sound like?
Listen to it yourself, records? Man, I couldn't tell you.
I have, and I wanted you to describe it, really. So, if you wanted to see a video the next, then what would that be? Anything.
Every Little Step I Take by Bobby Brown.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, quality.
Every Little Step I Take. Remember with the silly letters?
Have you seen the Boys version of that?
No.
Seen that band? You know that band, The Boys? That sort of mini band that came out a while ago?
The Boys. No, he's rejoined New Edition, he has.
Yeah, they're back.
That's great. Candy Girl. It's a great, great band. But now he's claiming he's better than the Jackson 5. It's like rather parallel to the Oasis thing, isn't it? Jackson 5 are like a little bit better than New Edition. I have to like remind Bobby Brown about that some time. We're both from Boston, by the way.
Yeah? Do you hang together in Boston?
I've never met the guy. But I've covered his ex-wife's song, How Will I Know, twice.
Twice?
Yeah, for B-sides. There's two versions. Acoustic version, which is rather more faithful to the original. And the other one, which I can't even explain to you, because maybe you'll hear it one day. It's like backwards and forwards and Devo and the Eurythmics and the Smithsonian Institute wrapped up into a tiny woven knot of Smashing Pumpkins, who I hate, by the way. Can't stand the Pumpkins.
Why not?
Why not? Exactly. Exactly, why not? I can't stand them. They suck, that's why. They're like completely like on the verge of a commercial. They're gonna be huge forever, and God bless them, but like their music is complete and utter nonsense. And it does not come from the heart. It comes from the shirt, I think, or something. I don't know. It's like two words I despise are Billy and Corgan. Put them together, you got a real problem. For me, anyway.
So, one of the stories about you, Evan, is that is when they were making one of the many stories about you is when they were making In Utero. When Nirvana
before,
and Steve Albini.
Before, I'll tell you the story. If
All
you
right.
Know the truth. I was on tour and I was like playing. It was the night I met Mark Curry, by the way. Playing an acoustic gig, and Christ and Dave showed up to the gig, and I played some Misfit songs for him and everything. We played at an art museum. Art museum, is that like a bit overkill? A museum of art or something. And me and Chris and Dave went to pick up Kurt at the hotel, and I was in the back seat, and Kurt gets in, he's like, we had to deal with it, right? And so we went and jammed for like 4 hours. I listened for like 3 hours, and we drank 4 bottles of red wine, and I played drums, and then it was Kurt and Chris and Dave. It was the first Foo Fighters rehearsal, actually, is what it was. I played drums, and like Dave had a song, and I played drums, and we were like, we jammed out, and we went and it was like total Wayne's World City, man, because there was a closed convenience store. And we rocked up, you know, we rocked up like only Nirvana can in Seattle. Like, the only problem, I was there too, but it didn't matter because they were there, all three of them. And they had closed like 20 minutes before, and they opened up the store for us again. It was great. We went home and like me and Kurt and, you know, Nirvana, yeah, and we hung out until about 5 a.m. and the rest is...
I was getting at them with Steve Albini calling you and pretending to be Madonna story, that story.
That was hilarious. That was really funny, yeah. Good on him.
Yeah. Next video? Like you're in charge.
Like a, oh, no, hold on. How about, wait, I just think for a second here. Videos.
Talk amongst yourselves.
Oh, God, Sybil. 27 people talking at once. Fuck them all. Okay, next video. You are now about to watch... How about, yeah, Sliver, Nirvana.
Deal.
Mom and Dad went to a show. They dropped me off at Grandpa Joe's. I kicked and screamed, so please, no. Grandma, take me home. 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 I had to hit my dinner there. Mashed potatoes and stuff and that. I couldn't chew my meat for good.
So your gum's somebody else's, by the way, on the shirt.
Gum, no, that's my gum.
Yeah.
I stuck that thing, my something. What was it? My sex and drug hell. I had this thing stuck. The only thing I could think of sticking in my shirt with is a piece of them.
So your sex, drug, celebrity hell, that thing's over now, or is it still going on?
This is from the paper, like about Oasis or something. Yeah, it is just hilarious. It's a funny thing to stick on your shirt. That's all. Problem is the gum's sort of committed to my shirt, but the thing is it'll come off because this shirt is made of like
asbestos or something.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
So what's this eight here? Is that an infinity deal or is it an eight?
Infinity that stopped at eight. Yeah, exactly. It was like actually I'll tell you the story about that. Me and Courtney and Green Day, we went and like rocked up at this. They played at Madison Square Garden. And I was like hanging out with Green Day, and they were telling me how they were big Lemonheads fans and stuff from the old days. We went and all got tattoos in the basement of a club. Of course, I checked that they had a clean, you know, needle for it. But yeah. And oh, this is a Germs tattoo, although it was scrawled upon by me last night. Right? That was the blue circle, the Germs. Fucking Germs, man.
Punk rock.
Yeah. Lexicon Devil.
So, you're in a movie with Liv Tyler.
Was.
Well, you will be, as far
and
as...
And were.
Yeah. Given a choice, had to marry Courtney Love, Liv Tyler, which one would it be and why?
I don't believe in the institution of marriage.
No, but I'm saying if you were forced.
live.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Why?
He's younger. She's younger.
Nice enough. So, any reason why anybody should buy the new Lemonheads record?
Absolutely none.
Do you want to list a few records people should buy before it?
Absolutely.
Hit me.
Pink Flag by Wire, the first Wire record. And Don't the Kids Just Love It by the Television Personalities. Definitely buy that before you buy Car Button Cloth. And the first five Black Sabbath records. Full Metal score of 4. Yeah?
Evan Dando. What, last video? What? Lemonheads video, another one.
Yeah, oh, I'll play it. My Drug Buddy, you got it. No, you don't. Yeah? Yeah. Play that one then.
All right, Lemonheads.
She's coming over. We'll go out walking. Make a call on the way. She's in the phone booth now. I'm looking in. There comes a smile on her face. There's still some of the same stuff we got yesterday. There's still some of the same stuff we got yesterday. Yeah.
General rock and roll style lunacy, Evan Dando returns with a new Lemonhead single about finding it hard to talk properly.
That's about it's about the fact that human beings can't really communicate with one another. If I could talk, I'd tell you. You know what I mean? Right. No, I mean, man.
If I could smile, I'd let you know you are the only one that I
Street. Of other things, but you know, they don't say, oh, you
there
know.
Are as many. I think one of the ultimate compliments is to have a song written about you. I finally have. It's not just any old song, it's not just any old guy. It's by the most gorgeous guy I've ever met, and a talented musician at that. And it's not just about me. It's about me, Alice, and Evan Dando. Evan Dando of the Lemonheads. Yes, Evan Dando, the Lemonhead sex god, has re-emerged. And guess what? One of the songs on his new album was inspired by Wild Weekends. My girlfriend Alice, Evan, and I spent at Glastonbury, New York, and London. I met up with him in New York to find out if those flames of passion were still burning. Evan, what is that? Is that a pistol in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me?
Oh, man. I'm so fucking horny, baby. I got a hat on.
Put that down, young man. Right. Control yourself. His protrusion under control, Evan serenaded me with his ode to our mad days and nights. It's all true.
I got me.
Ugh, the dork harmonizing on the right is me.
We got time to share.
You and I hooked up at Glastonbury.
Me, you, and Alice went off together to have fun.
To our country house in Bridport.
Yeah, with Mark and everybody.
You'd sleep over and we'd go back to the festival every day.
That was the best.
In the early 90s, the golden-haired all-American boy was hailed as an indie hero, but missing his Glastonbury gig was just one indication of a tumbling career. His self-confessed drug-hazed rock and roll lifestyle had become the focus of the music press, leading to a spell in a rehab. You were quite honest about drug use.
I don't know. It all goes back to things like William Burroughs and the Stones and stuff like that. Like, all the stuff I liked when I was 10 years old, they all like were really into drugs. And so luckily, I'm enough of a fuck-up that like people wouldn't want to take drugs. I'm an example of why you shouldn't take drugs. Yeah. But I knew if I was going to release another record that it had to be good because like people were so ready to just like totally write me off as a musician.
Yeah. My doctor.
Rockstars always have doctors.
I have to see my position for a moment. I'll be back in a second. In there.
I love Evan offstage, but by the time he gets on stage, I idolize him. Okay, yeah, I admit it. I'm a groupie. I took my bra off. It's a really expensive one. I hope I get it back. The audience is about 90% girls. But I think he loves me the most. Yeah, right. Backstage, Helena Christensen and I discussed Evan Day Dando fandom.
It's a good feel.
Evan is so cute that he gets all the beautiful people at his gig. It's really, isn't it? I mean, isn't he?
It's not
like
about beauty,
guy.
It's about mind. He's
it's
so mind color.
You have to admit, he's like the most beautiful guy
very,
you've ever seen.
Very cute. There
he's adorable.
There he is.
Adorable.
Hello.
Hello. You can all go away now. Yeah. Turn those cameras off.
We're having a private party.
Evan and I have some business to attend to.
Gonna make a baby.
And then most of you probably think of Lemmy as a hairy.
I mean, the government they replaced, I think, left.
Bye. Walk the wagon up till it. Thank you. song is for Chelsea.
Yeah.